Forever and ever, forever and ever. Yeah. stand here, one stand here. But facing the hearse. That's it. Next size is up.
So we get the crowd in. So it might be easier.
Try and start with your left foot, yeah. Make your way to the chapel, yeah. Get to the catafalque, just stop, off your shoulder,
thank you. I lift up my eyes from the Lord. From where does my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made the heavens and the earth. Good morning and welcome, brothers and sisters. We gather together to worship God, to give thanks and praise for the life of Jeffery, whose days amongst us here have come to a close. We are here to share our grief for one loved and respected by all those who knew him, and one whose own love and concern have through the years strengthened others. We are here to pray for the comfort and strength that God promises us, and to affirm the Christian conviction that while death marks the end of human life, it marks a new beginning in our relationship with God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ivan Berlin said, "The song is ended, but the melody lingers on." Let's all join our hearts together now as we sing our first hymn, "Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine." If you have a copy of the order of service, you'll find that the words of the songs are at the back of the sheet. Nothing in our hands we bring before you, Lord God, other than our broken hearts. Lord, we dig deep in our faith and in our hearts to try and find the right words, but we fall short. And here now, as we gather in your presence, Lord God, we acknowledge your presence. We know you are here with us, Lord God. And we pray that you may release your anointing and your power, that your glory may be revealed, Lord God. We pray that you will draw close to each and every one of us this day. It is a dark day. It is heavy, Lord God. But we just pray and ask for your mercy, that, Lord, you will come and say the words of comfort to us. We lift up the family, the friends, and the much wider community, that, yes, Lord, you have done your will. You have called back your child. But to us, it is a loss. That's the language we use. Help us in our weakness. In this time, Lord God, when we fall short, that you will strengthen us. We praise you, Lord God. We continue to thank you. Bless each and every one of us, and everything that we are going to do here, let it be about your glory and your power. We ask for all this in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior. Amen. Amen. We are supposed to say the Lord's Prayer. Let us all say the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thy is the
Amen. May I invite Ashley to come forward and share the eulogy.
I never thought I'd be doing this for my older brother. But I've just lost words. The last few weeks have been very hard for me, but God's watching over me, and God's giving me strength, so I'll be able to do it. So, Jeffery was born in 1993 at the hospital. My grandmother over there, and my father over there. He went to tell Alfred, he was in primary school. Then he was born in Morris, and he also attended Buckley Secondary School. I'm sure everyone here that knows Jeffery, knows my brother. He loved football. He loved football so much. I mean, he would get into arguments, everything. He could talk with about football. But that guy had a passion, and everyone here knew that. He supported Man United very well. We both supported Man United as well. I mean, everything Jeffery done, I did as well. So, literally. Watching football's not going to be the same again, I can definitely say that. He had a passion for football, so he played at Mitchell League, played at Wallace Wanderers, played for the Marines at Mitchell League. He plays the striker, he always thought he was better than me, but I'm good. He never got to see that now. He always, our dream was to be professional footballers. Wake up at 6 a.m. in the morning and go in the shower and just blaze music out loud and the bathroom's next to my room, so I could just, this guy wake me up, he just play music. So he loves music, that's one thing I can say about Jeffery. He had quite a few names in regards to music as well. During school, he called himself Tools Kid. I don't know where he got that name from. Then he called himself Jay Smalls. Then he rebranded himself as Smalls. He also attended Richmond College. He studied sports, so that's his education. Not sure how well he's done there, but Jeffery was a great man. I can actually say he was a great barber, great friend. I mean, he had great aspirations. He loved everyone. That's one thing I can say about Jeffery. And he always pushing the best for other people. Like, even for example, with just me, he would just tell me, oh, why don't you do this? Why don't you do that? Like, we'll get into arguments, we'll argue every day, but I can see where it's coming from. It's coming from the heart. Like, Jeffery always showed up. And like, sometimes I would say, I think, oh, you know, you're being annoying, like, leave him alone. But now he's gone, I'm just empty now. Like, I just, something's just missing. That's what it is. Jeffery, he's a great brother, great friend, great son, great husband, boyfriend, and you'll be dealing with this by your family. Look how much people are here today, look. The church is not even big enough. See, there's people. I'm sure there's probably people that start to pray there, but Jeffery, long live Jeffery, we love you. I love you as a brother. We love you as a family. Mom loves you. I love you. Long live Jeffery.
Thank you for sharing those words and tribute from Mom.
I'm reading for Mom. A part of me was snatched away on that fateful day. To lose someone so special is hard to bear. It hardly seems believable that you are no longer here with us, Jeffery. You left us far too early before your time. It seems now you will never have the chance to fulfill all the dreams. Jeff, as I always call you, who will take me to work? Why not even require a demand pack? Who will cook when I'm not able to cook for your siblings? Jeffery, I'm waiting for you to come and ask me, Mom, what's there for lunch? Our car rides will never be the same. Our short videos when we are driving. We will never be able to sing our hearts out together again. My heart is broken in pieces. Jeffery, you meant everything to me. You were everything a son could be. A big brother to Ashley and to Queenie. You were one in a million indeed. Your future looked promising and good. Your future could have been more so beautiful. Why couldn't death spare you? I have no answers because God knows best. My son, you are talked about with pride, with every mention of your name. Death cannot change a single thing. The love will still remain the same. Kwame, do my angel. May your gentle soul rest in perfect peace. Jeffery, Demi Fedri, Dwayne Amani.
Thank you for those moving words from Mom. We shall listen to the music now, just one verse of the hymn, Be Still My Soul.
Thank you.
scripture reading is taken from the book of Romans, chapter 8, from verses 31 to 39. Romans chapter 8, verses 31 to 39.
Romans chapter 8, verses 31 to 39, I read. What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword, as it is written. For your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No one is in all these things. We are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of God.
Thank you for reading the word of God for us. In my early days of Sunday school, we used to sing this simple tune, Jesus loves me, this I know. And I loved the part, the chorus, where we would repeat, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me, and yes, Jesus loves me, for the Bible tells me so. And before us is a question that is posed by the Bible or by Paul. What shall separate us from the love of Christ? Before us is a passage that gives believers reason to be confident. Not in ourselves, but in God who is constantly working in and through us in this broken world. In this letter to the Romans, Paul reminded them how challenging and unpredictable life can be. As he gave a list of things that has the potential to separate us from God and one another. If anything, we too have experienced these things. Since the turn of year 2020, we have been left feeling like we are walking through the valley of the shadow of death. And death is a present reality. And as such, we gather today. We stand as one people with broken hearts. No one here is all by themselves today. We stand as brothers and sisters, grieving because of the love we had for Jeffery. Therefore, what brings us here today is not grief, but love. Love for Jeffery who has died. Love that carries on in spite of death,
And with love, there is always hope. And our hope as believers does not disappoint us. Because of this hope, Paul made this declaration of his unshaken faith. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, no powers, no height, no depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. While my brothers and sisters believe in the truth of those words and God's unconditional love for you and me, I also know how difficult it is to understand these words and to let them speak to us at a time such as this. These words do not even attempt to provide any answers to the questions we bring. I would want to think that some of us here have said it loudly, asking those questions. And some of us are struggling with those questions silently. Because whenever someone as young as Jeffery, at 29 years old, dies, it is an absolute shock. It's something that society is not prepared for to accept. And even the Bible says, the length of our days is 70 years. Now, if the Bible says that you can make a calculation, those who are good in mathematics, 29, 70 minus 29, what do you get? And if we are strong, we live for 80 years. And today we feel robbed of Jeffery's gifts, his laughter, his kindness, his arguments. It is like witnessing parents bury their dreams and hopes. How can a parent outlive their child? Because no parent should have to bury their child. Actually, as parents, we expect our children to be the ones who bury us. Because that's the natural order of things. But today, it is the opposite. And the inevitable question comes up, why? Why, God, did it have to be this way? And many other questions we may have. It is normal to raise these questions. And even to be angry with God. But the question is, how long are you going to hold that anger, being angry? God. I want to believe that when we vent it out, God understands that this anger comes from a place of profound grief, a place that causes us to wonder or believe. And even Jesus hanging on the cross that day as he died, he cried out, my God, why have thou forsaken me? Grieve we must, brothers and sisters. Do not deny it. But we should also remember what the Bible says. Do not grieve like those who do not have hope. This our hope, which we hold on to, goes beyond our tears of personal sorrow and beyond the grave. And it is grounded in our acceptance of God's word that says, for God so loved the world. Or for God so loved Jeffery. For God so loved you and me that he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. With such an assurance, what then can possibly separate us from the love of Christ? I unfortunately didn't have the privilege of getting to know Jeffery the way many of you gathered here remember him. Difficult as this may be to understand or accept, just know that God's grace is sufficient for you. God is by your side. The Lord gave Jeffery, and the Lord has taken him back. May the name of the Lord be praised. You should be grateful to God for Jeffery, a son, a brother, a mate, a neighbor, a man who touched you with his life, character, values. And these will continue to touch you as long as you can remember. Talk about him and the ways he touched your life. To his mates here, friend, here present, what's the best mischief he ever got you into? What are the things that you did together? Your night outs? What were your best times with him? And what were your most difficult? To the family members, how are you going to honor Jeffery's memory? What is it that you're going to hold on to? Because it is Jeffery who wrote his life story. And no one can do it better than Jeffery himself. We must be thankful that it was such a precious and unique gift, and still is. You had him, and you have him still, not in your arms, but in your memory. Someone said the true place of the dead is in the heart of the living. Beloved in the Lord, none of this, all that I am saying, will undo what has happened. Neither will it end the grief you have today, because grief is a long and winding road. But the question is, who is your companion on this journey? We have a God who promises to be with us day in and out. Even in the deep valleys, in the gutters, we have a God who accompanies us. I don't know which team Jeffery supported, but to those who support Liverpool, you've got this beautiful slogan, "You will never walk alone." And that's powerful. To the family, you will never walk alone. You can rest assured to count on your friends and the community that surrounds you, and each and every person who is here today. Because we are here to support you and to guide you as you navigate through this hard and difficult journey. You can look at is with you. And this gives us hope. This gives us the confidence that there is a way forward. Even when we cannot know the way, even when we cannot see it, even when we are lost in our own thoughts, we are assured that there is a way. Friends, Paul says it, that nothing in all creation, nothing in this world, nothing in heaven or anywhere else can separate us from the love of God. Friends, when all else fails, when you no longer know what to do next, just remember these beautiful words of the song Jesus loves you. This I know,
read many books, but one thing that I know that sticks with me is that Jesus loves me. This I know, for the Bible tells me so. The Lord gave, the Lord have taken. Let's trust Him with what He has done. And just to pray and hope that one day we are going to join with Jeffery as we gather into the presence of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's pray. Almighty God, we continue to come before you to give you honor and glory, to worship you and praise you, Lord. Even in this time of loss, help us to trust you, Lord God, as we hear your word that says, your thoughts are not our thoughts, your ways are not our ways. We trust you, Lord God, that you saw it fit to call your child back to you. And here now, Lord God, we pray that you may help us to release him to you, Father God, and to trust in your word which says that death is not the end, but there will come a time when we will be raised gather in your presence. We just want to pray for each and every person here whose life was touched by Jeffery. And we just want to lift up the family, Lord God, who needs your grace and your comfort this time. God of peace, God of grace, we just pray and ask that you will continue to sustain your children. May your name be praised. May your glory be revealed here on earth. In the name of Jesus Christ, we praise you. Amen. Amen. May I invite Denise to come and give us the word of thanks. But probably before she does that, I notice that we still have a bit of time. We have a couple of friends who may want to come and say something. Thank you.
Firstly, I'd like to just thank everyone for coming here today to support and show love for Jeffery's friends and family as we celebrate his life. It's been hard writing this because of all the feelings involved, and the fact is, it's still hard to accept that he's no longer with us. And I would have said somehow it would have been easier for us to just sit alone and just cry, but alas, we promised to do this for a friend, and with promises, You don't break them, so we're here. I met Jeffery in Alphamism in year one, so almost a quarter of a century I've known this guy. And I was a new kid at school, and as any kids back then, how you make friends is, hey, what's your name? Are you good at football? So obvious answer is yes, you can play on my team. So from there, we've just been together ever since. You can call it Andy Cole and Dwight York, but he was definitely York, especially with his smile as the hype man,
even back then, the smile was infectious. We both went to William Morris in year four, and that's where we met Keith, and we met Humphrey. As we played for Little League. From then on out, essentially we were just the four of us. You couldn't separate us. You couldn't have two of us and not have the other two. We just came as a pack. And one of the funniest times that I remember was in William Morris, where Jeffery back then was a bit of a troublemaker. So I remember we was in two different classes at that time. I was walking to his class at the end of school, and I remember his year five teacher, Miss Poku, chased him round the classroom. Back then, you know, Jeffery was small, but he was also quick, he gave her hell. So Jeffrey's always been that type, you know, the personality was always been passionate, always been energetic, always showed love. And you could see it from, you know, everything that he did. He was so talented. He could rap, he could make music, he could cook, he could bake. Lockdown, he had us all eating sprinkle cakes and apple crumbles. Anything he put his mind to, he could do. And really true, that's some of the things that we're gonna miss him for. Also, his growth, as you know, as he got older, just the communications and the talking, the teaching that we had from him was, you know, this is what he wants to do in life. This is where his focus is. You could see the priorities were changing. And just, you know, as we all are, we're just sad that unfortunately God has taken him away so early that he could have put some of those into action so that we could all see it. Thank you. Wanted to say.
Again, thanks everyone for coming to support, respect, and show love to Jeffery. I met Jeffery at William Morris. Obviously, Jeffery and Gerald met first at Alpha Lisbon, so I was the last in the batch. So I actually blessed the batch for my presence, to be fair. But yeah, I met Jeffery in William Morris. We're in year four together. Again, when you meet someone for the first time, you find out what they're up to, what they are as a person. For Jeffery, we share the same last name, Adu. So that's how we became friends. And we realized we were actually related as well, the process, which is crazy. Again, we had a lot of similarities. I knew Jeffery literally at the back of my hand. He was my oldest friend. Again, if you knew Keith, you knew Jeffery. If you knew Jeffery, you knew Keith. Just as you know Ashley, you know Jeffery. We were like brothers on the roads, on the streets. We got to a lot of mischief, like growing up. There was one time, obviously Guardians would know this, a lot of Guardian currencies used to have like pound coins, and they're like, well, Founder City, they're like pound coins, should I say. So one time I took a pound coin with a 500 City coin, took it to Morley's and bought £2 mil, and it actually worked. Man, I know. Jeffery tried it and got caught. And the guy just grabbed his hand and just ran out of the shop, literally, it was crazy. But like, that was just literally like the tip of the iceberg of what we got up to over the years as we grew up. Again, as Gerald was touching on, he was growing, he was maturing. So many things that he was doing with his life that he could have done if he was alive. Like, just to touch base on like how creative he was as a person, when we were young, he could draw. I used to look at this guy and be like, how do you draw that? Like, we're like 9 years old, like, this guy could draw like cartoon characters vividly. And it's like, okay, this guy's actually creative. As we got older, to like secondary school, again, he fell in love with music. So we're like, what, 12, 13? So from William Morris, from like seeing each other every day, Monday to Friday, to like secondary school, where we just see each other every weekend, I used to see him on the weekends and be like, yo, how have you got a studio in your living room? Like, at 13, like, how do you afford this? But the guy used to self-teach himself to like learn new things, whether it be building a bed, building a cupboard, you know, just helping the family out just to help develop the household. He was that guy. And one thing I'm proud of is every single time that I saw him, I made it evident and apparent of how much I loved him. And I want to miss his laughter. I want to miss him as a person. I want to miss his advice, because he was such a positive person. I don't think you understand how loving Jeffery was. And the day of his birthday, I posted a video on Snapchat. And it was an embarrassing video, actually. It was in Dubai. He was dancing, and like, I just recorded it without him realizing it. And then I posted it on his birthday. And normally he's the first person to like comment on my snap or post on Insta, whatever it may be. So like, I just left it because he didn't respond within the next like 10 minutes. So I left it. So the next morning, I've woken up. As you do, you check your phone, you look at your snap, your online banking, your DMs, whatever it may be, you just check your phone. And I realized he didn't message me in regards to the video or view the snap. And like, I just had this innate feeling in my gut where it was just weird. Like, the spirit was talking to me. Within 5 minutes of feeling like that, my mother knocks on my door and tells me Jeffery's passed away. So even like processing that information, even until now, just looking at the coffin, like, I still don't believe it. Like, having a wake yesterday, just seeing him in there, I still don't believe it, because I will remember Jeffery for the loving and caring person that he was, and that lives on forever. Yeah, we come into this world in our physical body, but our spirit will always live on. He's with us right now in this room, sitting next to Uncle Kingsley, sitting next to his mum, standing next to Eugene. He's here with us. So, yeah, we may mourn the dead, but we must honour his life. Honor us by loving, giving us our flowers, just embracing each other, because we don't know when it's going to be our last day. And I know it sounds cliche, but it's the truth. I never thought I'll be here in January 2022 giving a eulogy for my brother, but to celebrate our birthday the other day. So I'm just going to keep it short. Jeffery, we'll honor your memory. And I'll always love you forever.
Sorry guys, you know I don't like public speaking. I just, before I read this poem, I just want to correct the boys there. I actually was the first one to meet Jeffery, and to fact check that, that was when I was 2 years old in nursery. Me, Mercedes, and Jeffery, and we reconnected years after that. I'll read this poem first. Sorry, it's just a short poem for Jeffery. We are here to celebrate your life and the measure of its worth, and every single life you touched while you were on this earth. We wish to pay our last respects. That's why we are all here, to thank you for your friendship and all the memories we hold dear. It's been a privilege to have known you. We were family, not just friends, and we will carry you in spirit and we until we meet up once again. We love you, Jeffery. Long live Jeffery. He's a very special brother to me.
we grew up together. And just like the other day, my mom was saying, my family nickname Chechang comes from him. My name is Nenecha, and the fact that he couldn't say Chechang as a toddler, that kind of stuck. Where do I go with this? I would always remember Jeffery for his love of music. Like other people have said, he loves to play music. I remember him sitting in his studio in the living room by the desktop, always listening to music. Before Shazam was an app, if I wanted to know a name of a song, it would be Jeffery I would ask. He was so special. He was so special. It's a great loss. Jeff is the most caring cousin and uncle to my children. I mean, he would go out of his way and drive all the way from Tooting to Thamesmead just to pick up my daughter from school, take her to the park, take her to McDonald's. I'm stumbling over my words because there's so much, there's so many memories, and it was a great shock. It was a great shock, but I just want to say how much I love Jeffery, how much the kids love him, and I'm just so thankful that he has a catalogue of music that we can go back and listen to, that is just positive music. Nowadays, when people are rapping, they talk about violence, they talk about women, but my children can always go back and listen to their uncle's music, and it has positive messages. God, I just pray his soul is with God, and yeah, I'm stumbling over my words, guys, and I hope you understand. But yeah, we love you, Jeffery, and yeah, it's a really hard goodbye.
Jeffery's girlfriend. I just want to tell you a quick story, because since everyone's talking about music. The first time I got into Jeffery's car, he was playing music, quite loud actually, because I'm not really a fan of loud music. And I was just sitting there just watching him. And then he was just like, do you not like music? And I was just like, yeah, why would you not think so? He said, because you're not moving, you're not dancing. I was like, what do you want me to do? Like, I don't have this energy that you have. And I was thinking, like, if I said I didn't like music, would that have just been the end of me and Jeffery? Because he loves music so much. Like, he would go to the toilet, bring the speakers, bathroom speakers, everywhere speakers. And I'm just like, what is wrong with this boy? But yeah, since everyone's talking about music, I just wanted to share that one. I'm just gonna read, because I wrote what I wanted to say. Listening to all the stories everyone has said of Jeff, I don't have to explain how Jeff was to anyone in this room. It only took me and him once to remember him forever. He was a lovely, funny, genuine person. To me, Jeff was my hubby, the love of my life. And most importantly, he was my best friend. We come as pairs, we would say. Everything was us and we whenever we said, and it was always lifetime and forever whenever we spoke. Being without Jeff these days has been the worst days of my life. I feel so empty and alone, and I know I'm surrounded by everyone, but it's just not Jeff. Jeff was my soulmate, plain and simple. I'm lucky to have had Jeff in my life. All it took was one look at his handsome face, and I just knew he was the man I was meant to spend the rest of my life with. And I didn't get the rest of my life with him, but I got the rest of his life. And I am the love of his life, and he was mine. And I am happy knowing that he knew that every day our time together may have been cut short, but the happiness and memories we shared together will last a lifetime. I will mourn the loss of my hubby, my best friend, my soulmate, my everything. But I will find comfort in the knowledge that he knows I love him to the end. Jeffy's a loving person to everyone. He always the one to reach out and sort things out. That's what annoyed me about him sometimes, because when we had our disagreement, he didn't give me the chance to do my EastEnders, like, oh, go away, you know, all of that. He didn't give me the time to be angry with him, and that's what I loved about Jeff. And I think that that's what we should take from Jeff as well, is that if there is something in our life that's troubling us, let's just resolve it, move on, and forget about it. So I am happy that Jeff left this earth with everyone happy with him and no situation left unsaid or about unresolved. We don't know what God's plan is, so we pray for guidance during this time. I will continue to miss Jeff until I see him again, but I will never feel alone because Jeff has left behind a love that cannot be broken. Jeffery Martin, Helen Kwame, thank you for everything. The bounds of King Jeff, I love you always and forever. Thank you.
If I could go back, I wouldn't be too consumed with time and trying to live my own life. I would just spend more time with family. And I think it goes to everyone in here. We're only given time. Life is a journey. So cherish your family, cherish your friends, and don't hold in bitterness, because life is not promised. I mean, I saw Jeffery. He's my cousin, he's my family, he's my blood. I never thought he was going to live such a short life. So if it's happened to Jeffery, it can happen to any one of us. So please, 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 I should leave here today. Make today a lesson to all of us. Don't hold grudges, because you never know. You never get time back. And if I can say anything in regards to Jeffery, when I moved from Belgium to here, the first thing I realized was Jeffery is a protector. He's always been the one protecting his mom, his dad, his younger brother. You can't say Jeffery without bringing Ashley in. So I know he's left a very, very big hole in our heart. But the God that gives us strength will help us to carry on. And I know Ashley's got a big shoe to fill. And I promise I'll be with him every step of the way. And we'll do our best for our family. That's all I want to take. God bless Jeffery and long live Jeffery. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'll allow a short video to be shown to us, which was prepared by Jeffery.
Hello, everybody, and thanks for coming. My name is Joseph. The last time I met Jeffery, that was in Mitchell. He was in his car, said, Uncle, I'm waiting to pick my auntie, Mami Sewa, and the kids home. I spoke briefly with him. That was the last time I spoke to him. Prior to that, he was in Mitchell one time trying to make a photo shoot, a video. And then there was this police officer around trying to stop him. And all I said to the lady, look, this is a guy who's going to bring her the Grammy. Forget it. I stood in the way of the lady because the guys were parking their cars just to make a photo shoot, and she was trying to stop them. I just stood there, and all he said was, Uncle, thank you. I got a video here, and I'm going to play to the crowd. Please exercise patience. It might not be so loud, but I hope it will bring some memory of the music that we talk about what he loves. Here we go. Not very good technician, but how do I make it loud?
No, when are you turn it to make it louder?
Bigger. How do I do it? Can you do it? Sorry.
Are you a retail seller or a brand owner doing business in Africa and worldwide?
Full screen, yeah. I'm not so good. I hope you enjoy the way it is. That's Jeffery. His memory leaves on. He always calls me uncle. I was a fan of entertainment back in the days in college, so when I saw it, I just couldn't walk away. I stood there, 19 body stores, entertainment prefect, and trust me, I was in this sort of thing, and I enjoyed it, and I could see a future in him. To be honest, I can't take it. But this is the life Jeffery lives on. His memory is still with us. He doesn't say much, but it's only in music. I see he knew the story ahead of him.
O God, who gives life and in whose arms we die, we entrust Jeffery to your safekeeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Receive one of your own, one in whom you have been at work, who carries with him our love. Welcome him into your presence, into the rest of everlasting peace, and into the company of all saints. Living God, in the mystery of your eternity, we are not separated from him, for your love holds us together. While we live, he will not be forgotten among us. In your eternal love, he will never be lost. May our memories of him enrich our lives. May the good things of his life leave a trace on earth. And may your keeping of him glorify heaven. The blessing of God the Creator, that surpasses all understanding, be with you all now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Where's the hearse, gentlemen? Rest in peace, Jeff.
Wait.
You're lifting.
Lower the head. Push.
Me.
Yes, go ahead.
For everything there is a season, a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to moan and a time to dance. We have come together in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen and ascended Lord. Through him, God has given us new birth into a living hope, which nothing can destroy or spoil or wither. We come to commit our beloved Jeffery into God's hands, where he will be safe and complete forever.
Amen.
We come to seek strength from God to face the unknown future without Jeffery's presence and support. We come to find a place of quiet calm in which we may express grief, private grief, before facing in public the wider world of Jeffery's circle of family, friends, and acquaintances. Let us pray. Almighty God, now we come to the final resting place of Jeffery here on earth. We pray that God, your strength will continue to work in us and through us. We pray comfort on each and every heart here broken. And we pray your grace will continue to sustain us, Lord. We also want to bless this place, that may it be a place of remembrance. And we thank you that you gave and now you have taken. May your name be glorified now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
May I invite the family members, if they so wish, to throw in the soil with me here.
Yeah. Okay, minute. Hold on, actually. Hold on.
Take a little minute.
Second, sorry.
Now that the earthly life of Jeffery has come to an end, we commit his mortal body to the ground, saying earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, trusting in the mercy of God, creator of all things, visible and invisible, and the victory over death of Jesus Christ, our Lord, to God be glory forever and ever. Amen. God will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. It will be said on that day, Lord, this is our God. We have waited for him.
so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. Amen.
Amen.
Let us all share the grace with one another. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Gentlemen, we need to come away from the grave so that the grave diggers can prepare it for, to be filled. We need to move right back, just over that side, so that the grave diggers can come here and move the matting.
God. You know that I'll be
away for a while without seeing each other. But I can understand why God would have wanted you close to me. Because you truly were an angel on earth. And my own special way. I love you.
And I'll take in the memories to be my sunshine after the rain. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. And I'll take
thank you.
makes beats.
Hustle and grind is the life that I lead. So much hurt and pain in the streets. I don't say much, me not tired to police. Keep myself to myself when the ends dog is peak. Hustle and grind is the life that I lead. So much hurt and pain in the streets. I don't say much, me not tired to police. Keep myself to myself when the ends dog is peak. You ain't fought what I fought, or the pain that I felt. Nah. Before you judge me, take a look at yourself. I see pain in the streets, so they're screaming for help. They're all free, but it's like they're all locked in a cell. The time is now, not later. I used to be bitter, but now I got flavor. I just begun, this is only a taste. If you're sleeping on me, fam, you best wake up. Wake up. The roads are getting worse, ain't getting better. Gray. Man, we let it rain, I ain't talking umbrellas. And the ends is mad sticky. You can get burst or stabbed, there's no pity. Madness. I remember Friday nights, we used to roll phones. And at New Year's Eve, when I nearly got poked. Life was precious, man, it's no joke. I could have been R.I.P. another story untold. I stay hustling and grinding. It will all happen in God's timing. Fuck the man there, I'm trying to do my thing. Hella snakes in the grass, calling pythons. Hustle and grind is the life that I lead. So much hurt and pain in the streets. I don't say much, me not tired to police. Keep myself to myself when the ends dog is peak. Hustle and grind
try dressing it up with it.
So much hurt and pain in the streets. I don't say much, me not tired to police. Keep myself to myself when the ends dog is peak. Life on the road is only two ways. You either go Joe with the early grave. Never too late, you can make a change. Together we can make a better place. Cause there's so many ways out the hood. Music or business, you ain't got a good. My dad told me focus on my books. Used to bunk school for ACs. Focus never could. Like single mom struggling. Man them will squeeze off just to get their money in. My hella beef over crap cause of one man's chat. Now another mom's crying cause she won't see her son again. I stay hustling and grinding. It will all happen in God's timing. Fuck the man there, I'm trying to do my thing. Hella snakes in the grass calling pythons. Hustle and grind, that's the life that I lead. So much hurt and pain in the streets. I don't say much, me not tired to police. Keep myself to myself when the ends dog is peak. Hustle and grind, that's the life that I lead. So much hurt and pain in the streets. I don't say much, me not tired to police. Keep myself to myself when the ends dog is peak. Your heart and your eyes, stay away from deception and lies, lies from Satan. You know this, so I got a
flee temptation that kills it. Satan, best move back, got salvation. Now you ain't trying to lose that. I'm thinking of Jesus like blue tack. Read it in Corinthians, I'm a new man. Run this race, as in the Lord, don't watch no face. But the enemies on my gaze, scant for the Lord like it's my grace. When I praise you.
Myself, Jay Smalls, brother Beans.
Done now.
Go hard or go hell, Potter's our soul, 2012.
Really my zone, furthermore compared and feel coming back down. Ready for the show? Woo. If not, hell, you will go like, let him know by the king of arts. Covering the not jeans. So you better recognize, 24-7, I'll be repping Christ. You could ask five man. He's still alive, yeah. But I see pay the fee. I ain't talking fines. Word.
They can't manage me. I've got these pagans shaking like a tambourine. His grace worth more than his salary. Christ be the one in charge, dead battery. In my rucksack, I be packing my Bible. Cutting up my flesh daily, suicidal. I ain't talking literally, but I'll be walking in faith and victory.
Young youths growing up without a dad. Mums broke so they put arts in bags. Repping for their council flat. Any second enemies can counteract dumb orders. Troubled teens with stress mind, gun holders. When it's beef they get knives, black smokers. And the sea with sex vines. Let them see and sense Christ. Pain is what a mother feels. It's what I've witnessed, this is something real. Nearly every girl's a Jezebel. Disregard those who try to tell him well. You're never too deep for God to dig you up. No number, get the figure out. Have you ever thought, what if Christ never came? Put your sin to the ground, Christ elevate.
People with a camera, these dons can't picture me.
Nah,
so I silence the haters, Mr. B. I ain't a Tilba, you can see the change in me. Street yes. Gospel, I don't flip. Ray in street. Like Anthony, I'm calm, mellow. Used to be a sinner, now I'm far from a rebel. Yo, all glory to Christ, car. Sitting at my heart, hard metal. Look, I be James Moose, forget the details. I ain't selling out my soul.
Deliveroo presents a world of groceries in the palm of your hand.
Secured the back and you secured all the windows.
Great job, guys. Miss Spark.
Can I offer you something to drink?
Listen, I really would love to, but I have some other jobs to attend to. Maybe another time? I do love your call.
Hey, if you ever need me,
can you put a system at this? Just let me call. Alright?
Thank you.
Yeah.
Guys, ready?
mics. Speaking of gratitude, I'm sure wherever Jeffery is, he will feel loved, because you guys and ladies, you blew our mind. We couldn't have done this without you. So we thank you, and we thank you, and we thank you once again for going through this journey with us. Although Jeffery has been laid to rest, and we know in God's arms, he will be resting in peace. I want to stand in, forgive me, I'm normally not short of words, but magic. I want to stand in the name of my family, and of course all the loved ones that were standing with us. Thank you for all coming and all sharing Jeffery's memory, love, and his journey with us. We will forever be grateful to you, and we'll never, ever, ever forget this day. God bless you all. As you're about to go to your house, may the good Lord guide your steps, bless your families, and everything that you do henceforth, may it be a blessing to everyone that you meet along the way. God bless you. Thank you.
A big clap for Jeffery, please.
Hardest day of my life, definitely say 100%. Well, the worst day of my life was the day I heard the news. Today is 100% the hardest day of my life. I'm lost for words, no emotions. Like, he might not see me crying, but I can't cry. I just have no emotions, I have no words to say. It still doesn't feel real. Literally, it's a surreal feeling. I feel like I'm lost, like someone snatched my heart away from me. But do you know what? With the support of all you guys here, like, look how much people are here today. All you guys support, you guys have helped me along the way. All the messages, all the calls, pictures. Gave Jeffery the best send-off we could. I mean, and this is a goodbye, this is a see you later, because one day, like this, what this situation has taught me, that we're all gonna die one day. So one day we'll see Jeffery in heaven. So this isn't a goodbye, Jeffery. This is a see you later. One thing also made me realize, which my cousin said in the church, is that don't keep any grudges against anyone. It's not worth it. I mean, you don't know when your time's up. Who would have thought that Jeffery would have passed a day after his birthday? Who would have thought that? I mean, we had big plans this year. We had so much things to do ahead. I mean, I lost my brother, my best friend, my rider, everything. I lost words, but thank you guys for coming. Hopefully I'll see you guys later. God bless you guys for coming. Jeffery, I love you from the bottom of my heart, Jeffery. We all love you as we're all here today. And yeah, see you later. See you in heaven, brother.
So thank you, and God bless you all. As we're about to leave here now to go to a reception, where you can all join us and of course carry on with the rest of the service. We posted the address on social media. It's everywhere on social media, so you'll miss it. And if anything, it's next to the big Tesco on Streatham. Yeah, so there's a church building which you won't miss at all, so we'd love to see you all there. Thank you. God bless. Yeah, when everybody's gone, I think you want to say a few words. Yeah?
Alright, so let's all go now.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we've come to the first part of the ceremony. We'll be continuing later on at the reception, which I believe will start hopefully within the next hour or two. You know, we should all be together. So stay tuned. We will go off, but if you want to join us later on here, within an hour, you could come back onto this channel, Dwumfour TV 2. And then you should find it, or you could search for it, just Jeffery's reception or Jeffery's funeral, Jeffery Martin Kwame Edu. Yeah, when you search for that, I believe you should find it. So, or you can subscribe so that when it comes on as well, you get the notification. God bless you all for the support and love that you've shown to this beautiful family. We pray that God will bless Jeffery's soul. God bless you all. Take care. Bye-bye.
Are you sure? Okay.
Thank you.